Welcome everyone. In our previous session, we have derived the expression for the thermal efficiency of actual Brayton cycle. Now, in today's session, I would like to start the numerical that is related with the actual Brayton cycle. So now, let's start our today's session and observe how to solve the example that is related with the actual cycle. So let's begin our class. Numerical number one. Given data, a gas turbine unit has a pressure ratio of 6:1. So here we have a pressure ratio, that is P2 by P1 is with us, which is 6. And the maximum cycle temperature of 610 degrees. So we have value of P3 with us, that is 610 degrees centigrade. Isentropic efficiency of compressor and turbine are 0.80 and 0.82 respectively. Okay, so we have turbine efficiency 82% while compressor efficiency is 80%. Calculate the power output in the kilowatt of an electric generator geared to the turbine when the air enter the compressor at 15 degree. So we need to find the turbine power with condition that whenever the air enters the compressor at 15 degree. So we have a value of P1 with us, that is 15 degree, and the flow rate of air is given, that is 16 kg per second. Okay, so mass flow rate of air with us, that is 16 kg per second. Okay, take the value of Cp 1.005 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, and gamma is equal to be 1.4 for the compression process, and take the Cp 1.11 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, and the value of gamma equal to 1.334 the expansion process. Okay, so for a given data we need to find the power that is developed by the turbine which is geared to the generator. Okay, so to solve this type of example, first thing that you need to do is you need to plot the TH diagram as usual. Okay, then second step, you need to find all the temperatures. Okay, I need to say T1, T2, T3 and T4. In addition to that, here we are dealing with actual cycle. Here we are dealing with the actual cycle. So you need to find two extra temperatures, that are T2 days and T4 days. Okay, then you are able to calculate the rest of the parameter like power, work rate and the efficiency, etc. Okay, so let's start this example with the plotting of TH diagram and the given data. Here we have given data, that is T1 is 15 degree, T1 is 15 degree, which is equivalent to 288 Kelvin. Then after T3, 610 centigrade, which is equivalent to 883 Kelvin. Then after pressure ratio, that is P2 by P1 is 6. Okay, so we have pressure ratio P2 by P1 equal to 6. Then after efficiency of compressor 80%, or you can say 0.80, efficiency of turbine is equal to 0.82, or you can say 82%. Okay, now with the given data we can proceed for the solution. Okay, and to proceed for the solution we need to plot TH diagram. So let's plot the system diagram and the TH diagram first. So here we have a system diagram as well as TH diagram. 1 to 2 is compression. Okay, 2 to 3 is the combustion process, 3 to 4 is again expansion, and 4 to 1 heat rejection. So first you need to plot the ideal cycle, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 on TH diagram. Okay, and we know that when we are dealing with the actual cycle, at that time you need to plot the actual compression and actual expansion process. And to plot actual compression and expansion process, we need to plot one path which shows the increase of entropy during the execution of particular process. For example, here you can say 1 to 2 is ideal compression, while 1 to 2 days is actual compression during which entropy increase. Similar way, 3 to 4 is ideal expansion, while 3 to 4 days is actual expansion, which shows the increase of entropy during the execution of expansion process. Okay, so here we have a system diagram as well as TS diagram with us. Okay, clear? Now based on this diagram, we need to find all temperature first, T1, T2, T3 and T4. In a given data, we have only two temperature with us, that are T1, T3. Now we need to find T2, T2 days, T4 and T4 days. I mean to say, we need to find four different temperature. So to find T2 and T2 days, we have one parameter with us, that is pressure ratio, that is P2 by P1. So just use the basic thermodynamic correlationship. Okay, T2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. But here we are dealing with the compression process, so you need to take gamma for the compression, that is 1.4 provided in data. So based on this, okay, you will get T2 by T1 is equal to 1.67. Just try to calculate. Okay, you will get T2 by T1 is equal to 1.67. Okay, so if you simplify further this equation, you will get value of T2 is equal to 481 Kelvin. Okay, clear? Now, you know that the compressor efficiency is given by the isentropic compression work divided by actual compression work. Isentropic compression work MCP T2 minus T1, while actual compression work MCP T2 base minus T1. MCP cut out from the numerator and the denominator, so you will get efficiency of compressor is equivalent to T2 minus T1 divided by T2 base minus T1. Now we have value of T1 and T2 with us as well as efficiency value with us. So just put those value and try to calculate the unknown parameter, that is T2 base. Okay, so try to calculate, please. So after the calculation, the value of T2 days is equal to 529 Kelvin. Okay. So now we have T1, T2, T2 days and T3 with us. Now we need to find T4 and T4 days. Okay. So to do so, just apply the same thermodynamic correlation, that is T3 by T4 is equal to P3 by P4. Raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. Okay, but we know that during the combustion and heat rejection, pressure remains constant, so you can say T3 by T4 is equal to P2 by P1 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma, where P2 by P1 is nothing but the pressure ratio, which is equivalent to 6. Okay, because it is provided in data. So just to try to calculate, as I told you, just put the value and you will get T3 by T4 is equal to 1.565. But you need to keep one thing in your mind. Here you need to put value of gamma, which is provided for the expansion, not for the compression. For the compression, the value of gamma is 1.4, while for the expansion, the value of gamma is equal to 1.33. So based on this, you will get T3 by T4 is equal to 1.565. Okay. Now you have value of T3. Okay, that is 610 centigrade. Try to convert into Kelvin and try to find unknown parameter, that is T4. So based on the calculation, the value of T4 is equivalent to 564 Kelvin. Clear? Okay. Now we have turbine efficiency with us, I mean to say isentropic efficiency of expansion, that is 0.82. So we know that the isentropic efficiency of expansion is equal to T3 minus T4 dash divided by T3 minus T4. Okay, we have derived this equation in our previous class. So based on this, okay, just to put the value of different temperature, you will get unknown parameter T4 dash, which is equivalent to 621.4 Kelvin. Now we have all temperature with us, so we are able to calculate the power developed by the turbine. Okay, as well as compressor. The compressor work is equal to Cp T2 base minus T1. So for 1 kg of flow you will get compressor work is equal to 242.2 kilojoule per kg. Okay, 242.2 kilojoule per kg. Now next we need to find turbine for kg, okay, or you can say for unit mass. Okay, so turbine work Cp multiplied by T3 minus T4 is, we have all temperature with us, just put the value of temperature in the Cp. Okay, here the Cp is equal to 1.1, because for the expansion and the compression value of Cp as well as gamma both are different. So just go through the data. Okay, for the turbine, or you can say for the expansion, the value of Cp is 1.11. So based on this, turbine work is equal to 290.4 kilojoule per kg for the unit flow rate of air. Okay, now net work done is nothing but turbine work minus compressor work. So just put the value, you will get net work done is equal to 48.2 kilojoule per kg. Okay, and if you multiply 48.2 kilojoule per kg with the mass flow rate of air, you will get total work done, or you can say total power that is generated by the turbine and the generator unit. Okay, which is equivalent to 771.2 kilo. Okay, so it is all about the today's example. In today's example, we have solved the example that is related with the actual Redox cycle, and we have observed that how to utilize the equation of turbine as well as compressor efficiency in order to achieve the unknown temperatures, or you can say to achieve the actual temperature after the compression and after the expansion. Okay, so it is all about the example that is related with the actual Bredel cycle. Thank you.